Hey everybody, welcome to UltraChenTV. I'm James Chen, and you are watching this on twitch.tv/jchenzo. As you can see, there is a new emote now. I have created Chen Rage, which I felt like was very appropriate, considering usually what happens during matches, especially ones that involve Urien. So now you have stuff to spam out whenever the frustration builds up here on this side. So you have something to share my rage in the chat, to share alongside my rage. That's right, it's Chen Rage is the new emote. That's the third emote. I have more coming. Some stuff planned, and I'm still working on those, so they will be around shortly. But welcome once again to UltraChenTV. This is Learn to Fight series, where you guys watch me play Cammy online, and I talk about my mindset while I play and how I keep learning. And it's also interesting to watch me try to get up to this platinum rank, which I have been striving for quite some time now, and have not been finding much success. And you know, what's interesting about that is that it's really just teaching you about little things. Like I keep developing little extra things to my game, adding things to my game, and really trying to learn to anti-air, which I have not been doing. But the lesson to learn from last week, as you watched last week, was be properly nourished and get some sleep. Now, I actually did eat lunch before I came to play today. Getting proper sleep will never happen for me, okay? Because my brain just doesn't want to work that way, and I stay up very late. So we'll see how I do today when we go online, but just a few things that I gotta continue to remember. One thing is, last 2 weeks ago, one of the things that I really learned was, you know, trying to mix up between dashing forward and jump roundhouse dive kick. So at this range right here, where I'm playing this dance, dashing forward is a very scary thing to deal with. However, if the opponent is ready for it, they can punish me when I dash forward really badly. However, if they're looking for that, I can surprise them with a roundhouse dive kick, because it's at perfect range, if you notice. And I can even get the two-hit combo, because it keeps hitting them in the stomach and in the shins. So that's something that's I gotta remember to add back into my game. Get into this range and either dash forward button or roundhouse dive kick, instant roundhouse dive kick. And those, mixing those two up, I feel like is something really good. Something I forgot to do last week, probably because I was tired and didn't have any food. So I'm gonna go ahead and start playing here. Yeah, there are definitely two different kinds of rage. One from the Ultra Chen channel, obviously, and one from the J Chenzor channel here. And are you making me punch Sejam? That's actually the funniest damn. Oh my god, that's genius right there. How do you get that Sejam emote? Sejam what? Okay. Oh, that's hilarious. That's hilarious. Okay. You guys can see that up there. So, God. So what I'm going to be doing is going online and trying to make sure I keep that up. And then I've got to get back to this anti-air kick again. I got to make sure I can anti-air. I'm also wondering if it's going to make a huge difference, because I also got myself a new TV finally. So you guys probably remember that I had a situation where one of my monitors was dead, and so I was streaming and everything from one monitor, which was really kind of a pain. So I was going to get a new monitor, but then I was like, you know what, this doesn't really make much sense. Thanks for the follow, Lemonin. It doesn't really make much sense because... and actually, let me move that follow up a little bit to, because I remember people wanted the alert box to be a little bit higher, like in a way where it doesn't block the entire match. But so I'm gonna move it a little bit. But instead of actually getting a new PC monitor, what I did was I took my Asus monitor that I was playing on and moved it over here. So now it's the PC monitor. And I got myself a TV so I don't have to squint and look at damage and all these things like that. I can actually see it from where I'm standing, from where I'm sitting. Oh no, I forgot to hit apply settings. Oh, come on, they gotta change that. They gotta change that. There we go. So now I can actually read stuff like the damage. So if I want to know how much damage this does, I can actually read it here. It's 188. I don't have to do this anymore. So once again, shout outs to displaylag.com for helping me find a nice TV. It's a giant database full of TVs and different lag times. So you definitely want to check that out if you're ever trying to buy a new monitor, especially if you're trying to buy one for fighting games. Because fighting games, it's super important to make sure your lag is good, and so that site is the best. Displaylag.com. Displaylag.com is definitely where you want to visit, so... I always put the 3-5 connection, but I don't ever accept 3 or 4. The problem is if you set it to only 5 or 4-5, you actually get less people that you pair it up with. You always pair up with the same people over and over again, and oh god, it's a fun. And I am not good at fighting this character because I do not fight this character very much, so let's do this. Alpha 3 question? Holy crap, that's interesting. Alpha 3, back heavy punch, jump medium punch are your friends with Sodom so that you can zone the air against Rolento. But here we go, I got a fight Fong, and not an easy... Why did I do that? That was already a terrible start that I know doesn't work. I did not jump, but I will accept it. Whoops, I meant to jump there. See, good angle on the shins there. Why did I backdash? Caught him by surprise. Throw him again. Yeah, now let's do the knee. Yep. Okay. This should kill. Yep, there we go. So that's my standard mix-up at first, is throw again, and then knee. Because the knee looks like you're walking forward. So I want them to throw tech or hit buttons. So that's the goal right there. Rio Benda. Yeah, that's fine. That's you're just setting those out, but you're not doing anything, so I don't have to panic. Ooh. Ooh, you just did Tor's heavy kick. Ooh, didn't get under it. Oh, nice throw tech. Oh, he just did it. Oh no! Too far. Now he's playing defensive. Ooh, touching buttons. Oh, okay. Ooh, more buttons. Oh, that should have been punished. My bad. How did I not get under him? I knew he was going to do that! I knew he was going to do that! And I was trying to bait it out! But I walked forward right when he did it! Oh my god. Oh, too far. I should be confirming 2 crouch light punches. Finally got under him. Okay. Just so the trick to Fung, really honestly, is when you fight against him, don't let his Ryobenda Nishikyu stuff make you want to get in. Because if you notice, when he does Ryobenda Nishikyu and I just backdash away from it, he's not getting anything except for screen space. My biggest problem against Fong is when Fong starts doing that, I really want to get in. I really want to keep attacking, and I really need to learn not to do that, to be okay with just kicking back a little bit. Oh, I stood up. Why am I standing up? You don't have to stand up to block Nishikyu. That's very important to note. And he does like that. Oh, I got crush countered. Okay, tiny bit of hit. That's not a problem. EX shoulder, EX sleeves, yep. And I walked forward into it. I was calling it out right there. I didn't think it was going to hit me from there. Oh, that was just annoying light button pressure. But dude, I was like, he's gonna sleeve, he's gonna do sleeves, and then I walked into it anyway. That's like Urian tackle, except he doesn't get anything out of it. Oh, you like low strong, low roundhouse too much. I just cornered myself. Good, I got out of the corner. That was the goal. Oh my god. Okay, nice throw. And this Q doesn't do anything, so it's okay. Oh, shoot. Oh, nice escape out of the corner. I like it. I'm trying to catch Ryobenda, but he's just hitting buttons, and I mistimed my meaty that time. Alright, okay, okay. I just mistimed my meaty when he threw me. That's fine, that's fine, that's fine. James the Powerhead, I don't know if that's more of an insult to me or an insult to the people who got invited to the E-League. Come on, man. That's not fair to those guys over there. Well, all of those players there are really good players. And I've always said, you know, playing is also not necessarily, like, if you're in an esports position and you're trying to become a top player, being really good is one thing, but also having a good personality is another. That's just part of the game, right? I mean, that's how it works. So I have no problems with that. Lan What asks if I can do some third strike on Fight Cave. That would be awesome, except I'm terrible at third strike. I'm not good at it at all, so if I went on Fightcade, I would get bodied. I could play some Super Turbo on Fightcade for sure. That might be really fun to do. But I'm not particularly strong at Third Strike. My Third Strike game is very weak. Interesting. That always combos, huh? Yeah, I guess it does. So even at top of head medium punch like this, combos into crouching strong, so that's good because that's the combo I should go for when I hit that. So, because I used to go for lights and you lose a lot of damage for that way, but I use lights just to make sure I could combo. But looks like 5-frame crouching medium punch is fast enough. Yeah, I know, James the Powerhead. I know you're kidding. It's all good. No, actually, I'm mad. Someone please post a Chen Rage in the chat for me at James the Powerhead. Damascus saying, is this gonna kill? Dude, like I said, whenever you get hit by a super that you're not sure if it's gonna kill or not, I don't know. It just comes out because what else is there to say while you're waiting for this big, long old animation to finish? You're just like, is it gonna kill? Is it gonna kill? And besides, at least it builds some form of suspense, right? Like, if I'm just like, yeah, it's gonna kill, or nah, it's not gonna kill. Like, I just think it's more fun that way to be like, is it gonna kill? Here we go, Buki. Kunais, run away, Kunais, run away. Yep, there we go, Kunais. And then towards heavy kick, which is always a scary thing to deal with, so I'm gonna poke, because she's trying to do the... Okay, good start on the no anti-air. Okay, Ibukis like to teleport, and not only do they like to teleport, but this Ibuki has some lag, and that never goes behind. I don't know why I always fall for that. It never goes behind. That setup always looks like it's supposed to go behind, but it does not. And everybody falls for that. It's when they do that low roundhouse, stand roundhouse, teleport forward, it always looks like she can get behind. I need to go into the lab and find out if going behind is even possible. Okay, teched. So she teched, so that's good news. That's for Shimmy now. Oops. That was a defensive throw, so I accidentally threw her backwards. Just gotta hold that. Okay. See, Ibukis like to teleport. Why am I not ready for that? It's what you should be ready for every time you're blocking an Ibuki. Oh, I didn't think that was gonna cross up. Oops! I just dropped my combo. That was terrible. I'm going to lose a lot of life for that. And somehow I live. Alright, thank you, Jansen Lives, for the subscription. Appreciate it very much. Somehow I won that. I don't know how. Nope, bad range on that. Oh, that's, it should be punishable. I just did not use a fast enough move. Okay, twice in a row I've done that now. I've got to be smarter about that. See? Ooh, nice. Oh, laggy lag. Oh yeah, he's getting lagged too. Okay. Okay. See, there it was again, the teleport. Oh, that time I went behind, okay. Oh, jeez, okay. Well, that got kind of laggy at the end, so Thotakan, I will grant you that victory and we will move on from now. So that got a little laggy, and according to, I think it was Frame Trap Tom, he says that the lag only continues to get worse, so... Sorry, sir, that was just laggy, so... Alright, let's move on to the next person. Thotakan, I mean, he probably pronounced it correctly, right? Lisp doesn't switch the S's and the TH's, so it wouldn't be, all of a sudden he wouldn't go, hey, it's Thotakan! Oh, man. Whiff punishing is so hard, dude. It's so hard. I wish I could whiff punish in this game, but I'm already a terrible whiff punisher as it is. Then you make the game to the point where it has that 6.5 frames, and now all of a sudden it's a real problem for me. So mid-screen, what's the best damage I can do? Yeah, that's just too hard to do consistently. So at one bar, mid-screen. Whoa, did it just lag on me even here? Mid-screen, it's probably that and the uppercut is probably the best combo. Like so, that's 336 for 1 meter. What is, that's 306, it's not very good. What's this? That's 308, not very good. So yeah, middle of the screen. So mid-screen you wanna do into that for 336. If you want to be able to maintain pressure, you do that instead for 313, and that gives you pressure situation. Ooh. This is not good so far. Oh, look at that. I still have time. Let's test this out. Do I have the wake up recovery on crouching light punch right now? Yes, I do. Alright, so let's test out what my setups are off of throw. Oh, perfectly timed, too. Just dash up and medium punch. Okay, so mid-screen it might be worth doing this just so I can still have the pressure, because when you do this, whoops, into uppercut, Oops, wrong one. If I do this into uppercut, you basically get no pressure anymore. See, you lose the pressure in that situation. So it might be better to do that, the hooligan throw from time to time. You get 20 less damage, but you get better pressure. So, Punk uses block strings to whiff punish, and you should be able to whiff punish most heavies on reactions. Yeah, he does buttons that leaves him into a range where the whiff punish works so that you can just react to any button and hit anything. But it's still dangerous because that's the problem. One is I'm too scared still to try to hit buttons at that range because I'm afraid they're faking. So I overthink things a lot of the times. And oh my god, we've got a 6400 cami. Kill a season. Is this kill a cam? Is this kill a cam? I wonder. But I have trouble in this matchup. I don't do very well in mirrors. And I especially don't do very well in cami mirrors. Whoops. I wasn't sure what side she was going to end up on. Okay, good throw. Wake up, uppercut. Wow. Okay. Yeah, I gotta fix that problem. Nice back medium punch. Someone has anti-airs that I do not. No, you don't. No, you don't. You try to walk up and it is a little laggy. It's a tiny little bit laggy. Round two. Well, that was unfortunate. We're just hitting buttons. We are hitting buttons, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, that's fine. Now you have no super. I'm okay with that. Oh, Jesus. Neither of us was ready for that. Oh, what a terrible meaty timing. I tech the throw! Oh my god! That was such a beautiful backdash on his part. He was trying to bait my dive kick and that backdash was beautiful, but he didn't get anything off of it. That's really unfortunate. Yeah, dude, Cammy's alternate outfits are all terrible. Only this one I kind of like. I really like the story mode costume if they just gave her freaking pants. Like, I would actually be happy with that, but, like, this is the best one. As long as you take off the ugly... Oh, you ran away! Okay, so, I don't think that was assault kind of thing. I think that was probably more... It was a little laggy, and the guy was probably like, you know what, I don't want to deal with this, so I'm not going to bring out the salt shaker for that one. Actually, the salt shaker is only for rage quitters, to be honest with you. He at least played that match all the way through, so that's good. Yeah, I know, right? Cammy never had any pants. Doesn't mean she can't start at some point in time to have pants. Oh, man. I mean, it would even be better if the outfit that she had with that coat, it was actually like a full one-piece outfit under the coat, you know? But it's like, it's clearly she's just lacking pants, and that's it. God, oh my god, the crouching jab did that thing where it pushed me away. I thought that was... Yeah, it does look a lot like Karen. It's just that it's different than what, you know, it normally is. But that was crazy, you see that? That crouching light punch did that thing where it pushed me away and I couldn't combo. See? So I'm gonna actually have to do Standing Fierce in that. Obviously it's just a Karen thing with that particular button, but still, that's good to know. God, it's weird how it does this lag thing right now whenever a match is about to come up. I remember David mentioning that in the beta a long time ago, but I'm noticing it really, really heavily today. It's like before a match comes out, all of a sudden, even training mode offline starts going, and then all of a sudden the match comes. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, this outfit doesn't fit Cammy at all. This outfit does not fit Cammy at all. I just wanted to try to play something that's different, and I don't like any of the alt outfits that they've given her. Like, I think they're all not good. I would get the story mode one, because, like I said, I really like the way that one looks. It's just that one little detail that bothers me, so... I have seen the mod that loads things very quickly. It only works for PC, unfortunately. Bison. Well, you know this is supposed to be a body for Bison, so if you put any sort of anti-pants subconsciousness into her, that means he just doesn't want to wear pants. And he clearly is okay with wearing pants. Not a good distance. Bad dive kick. Nope, bad distance. That was heavy, heavy is the safe one. Okay, just changed right there from block skins. Nope, bad distancing again. I should use the EX at that range because the EX one reaches. Oops, he just decided to jump. And he didn't do anything. Yeah, mutual jump really kind of screws up Bison's offense. And that's something that I wasn't doing enough the first few times I played against Bison, which is one of the reasons why I had trouble fighting him. Because if you try to fight him from the front like everybody all the time, you're going to end up in a situation where he can scissor kick you for free. Let's throw again! Oh, he jabbed, okay. Oh, ow, nice confirm. Oh, nice. That was crazy. So fast. Whoops. None of that was intentional, but it looked sick. I mean, that was my new mix-up. I've wanted to practice this new mix-up into Hooligan Slide. And then go up for the throw and catch him off guard. That's my mix-up. Yeah. The battle costume's okay. It just makes her look like Jack and Daxter. It kind of gives her this Jack and Daxter look.
Round one.
Fight. Oops, I forgot to take off the white thing. I really like that. Oh, he just missed? Ow! Oh, I just dashed into it. Don't touch anything in the middle of... Okay. No, why did I do that? Ugh, I don't know why I did the reset there. I just didn't think that standing medium punch was gonna combo. I'm supposed to do crouching medium punch. I was talking about that last session and I just, Okay, he likes to touch buttons, so dashing in on him is not gonna work. But he's probably noticed that I'm not hitting any buttons, which is why he's going ham right now. And then he V-reversals. Why did I do that? That was a weird reaction to a jump, was to jump at him and get hit. Okay, he needs to dash up and throw is what he needs to do. Okay, see, I stopped neutral jumping there. That's what gave him that liberty to do that scissor kick there. I like how the discussion is still about pants in the chat. I love it. What the hell? Okay, let's get the throw in there. Oh, nice whip punish. Okay, I gotta stop hitting buttons after that knee. I keep doing that. And I keep getting hit by that, so that's just my fault right there. Oh, that's interesting. Whoops, I meant to super, but I didn't know which way he was gonna end up, but I still got the stun! Woo! Okay, okay. I wasn't sure if he was gonna end up in the corner or not, so I was like, which way do I super? Which way do I super? And then when I figured out he was in the corner, it was too late. My mind had decided he was not gonna be in the corner. I couldn't switch my code around to do the uppercut, to do the super fast enough, but it came out as the uppercut, so I got the damage anyway, so. Oh, okay. Yeah, there is going to be a maintenance tomorrow, and the maintenance is going to probably be the release of Colleen. So it'll be pretty cool. After the release tomorrow, there will be some Colleen, and lots of people will be experimenting with that character. We will, of course, do a Tuesday show. Maybe we should just do a Tuesday show and have a whole segment where we actually play with Colleen for a while. That would actually be pretty cool. I'm going to think about that for a second. Think about how to set that up. That would be cool to set up something for Colleen tomorrow. And then after that, Wednesday morning, I'll probably do an Ask Jay Chenzor session while I mess with Colleen. If you guys are not familiar with that, on Wednesday afternoons, I never streamed because I was always editing shows. But you know what? I want to stream more, so I'm going to stream on Wednesday morning anyway, and what I'm going to stream is I'm going to stream an Ask Jay Chenzor Execution Corner episode where if you want to ask me questions, and this is just to help you learn about fighting games in general. This could be about how do I pick a character, what's the mindset about this, how do I go from Street Fighter to Guilty Gear, how do I go from Street Fighter to Tekken. Hey, I'm a Guilty Gear player and I want to learn Street Fighter. Hey, James, what's your favorite kind of pasta? Hey, James, what toys did you play with while growing up? You can ask me anything you want for Wednesday. All you have to do is send an email to ultrachentv@gmail.com with the subject line of Ask Jay Chenzor. You can also... Isn't this the same guy that I just fought? No, it couldn't be because he says he has 2 wins. This is a different Bison. But basically, you can ask me any questions. You can also ask me if I can help you with certain combos. I have trouble doing this combo in Street Fighter V. I can't do uppercut FADC in Street Fighter IV. Hey, in Guilty Gear, I can't do this combo. Hey, I've seen this complicated combo in KOF 14. Can you help me? I will do my best to help anybody with any combo, even if I'm not particularly good at that game. I'll try to learn it because that would be fun. Okay, don't hit buttons. Okay, dash throw, Bison. I gotta get used to that now. Oh my god, he actually slid at me. Wow, that hit me. Oh my god, I love that buff, by the way. That dunk, it's like my favorite thing. Where's my dash? I actually tried to dash. It didn't dash. I tried to forward dash after the head stomp, it didn't dash, and so I walked right into that and died. This guy has really good head stomp usage.
Okay.
was really dangerous. I don't know why I didn't confirm those lights into the drill. Something in my head told me it was gonna fall dizzy, but there's no reason not to drill anyway, just in case it didn't. So that was really terrible on my part. That was beautiful, but that's punishable. Oh, God. Just patience and be defensive. Just want to avoid that. Nice. Oh. So this is, I mean, like, I'm fighting bison a lot better just because I'm being patient. A lot of the times when I lost to bison and when I was losing to Fong and all those characters is because them standing there whiffing buttons and throwing Nishikus and throwing Ryobendas always was like an invitation for me to try to go in and attack them and fight them and fight them, and I kept jumping into a lot of their stuff. But I have to realize that sitting back and doing nothing is a frustration for them. And that I can actually bait them into coming after me, like so. I was expecting that. Why are you doing that? Wow, you will not stop getting hit by that trick. This bison will always hit something after standing light kick, so I can do standing light kick, crouching light kick in the drill all the time. That combo he was doing against Yurian, huh? Okay, I can try it. Okay, now he's not hitting buttons. I still got hit by it because of the hit stop froze me. Ay ya ya. Not a teleport, that was a scissor kick. I was trying to punch the teleport. There lies one of the powers of the V-trigger scissor kick. Makes it more confusing that way. Block this time. That's why I'm trying to forward dash through that, because it's just a nice little mix up. And I knew it to delay my standing medium punch after the super, because immediate medium punch does not actually hit quick rise. And they can't back roll off of that. Okay, okay, okay. I'm only your third Timander? Or are you talking about somebody else? I really, really hope that I'm higher than third. Come on, man. Jeez. Oh, man. To put in the next donate banner at the bottom. What do you mean, Muffin Man? What are you actually trying to... What do you mean? Do you want me to make an Ask Jay Chenzer info blurb to put next to the donate banner at the bottom? Oh, I see what you're saying. To actually, like, write. Actually, that's a great idea. That's a great idea. I think I'm going to actually do that. So. Hey, what's up, Tatsu Shoryu? I'm not the best Cammy. I'm absolutely terrible. So, and I'm doing well. Killick, how's it going for you? If you are indeed Wesker Killick, I don't know if that's actually you. I don't know what your Twitch handle is. If that's you, Steven. Rom doesn't like Street Fighter V. Well, he's probably frustrated because Vega didn't really get that much better. He actually got better, it's just not enough better, to be honest. No, that's way earlier than I thought. It's too hard to be a consistent thing to go for in an actual match, because if you miss it, you die so badly. It's just fun to do in training mode because it's like one of the main challenging combos that exists in the game. So I just like doing it just for that reason only. But outside of that, like, there's really not much to do in training mode for combos. And sometimes I just want to flex my hands to do like combo stuff. There's really not much to do in that sense here. You can really just test things out. Which actually, interestingly, I feel like does make me a better player because I'm actually testing things out in training mode. Which is good. You should be testing things out in training mode. But for some other reason, I just really like to do combos. Who do you think are the top 5 American SF5 players right now? Do you think Punk or Idom would be in there? Punk for sure is in there. I need to see Idom travel, because the thing about it is Idom is super good, but so far he has the problem where he's only played in the area that he's familiar with. You really start finding out about players once they start traveling to different places and playing over there. Now, Idom has definitely traveled to some of the Philly tournaments and such, but I really want to see what happens when he goes to West Coast, if he goes to Texas. If he goes to, you know, a further tournament, or CEO, for example, Combo Breaker, these kind of things. So, okay, a legged legend, or a leagued legend. Scary Ken players? But you can't wake up uppercut, so what am I scared of? Okay, well, that was a Cammy round if I've ever seen a Cammy round. That was pretty much what Cammy wants to do. Oh my god, sweet! Oh, cross counter. Oops. Okay, lots of neutral jumps. I gotta watch out for his neutral jumps. Nice. And his regular jumps too, which I am not anti-airing. Oh, Jesus! I was getting ready for that jump and I did nothing again! I'm the absolute worst. Nice. Oh dang, that was so far, I forgot he had that. I forgot that was an option. Okay, something to keep in mind. Jesus, James, really? Yay! First one of the day. Sucks at that trays because it's the roundhouse uppercut. Nice. It wasn't a counter hit. It's only counter hit like punch. It's only counter hit like punch that works with. Ooh, he went crouching light. He went crouching light. I thought he was going to go overhead. Okay, yeah, that was just my fault because I hit him with a crouch light punch into V trigger and then I went for standing medium punch. That's not a combo. It's just supposed to be raw uppercut. Standing medium punch only works in that situation if you have a counter hit. So that's my fault. And then I forgot to. Yeah, I have to use the medium uppercut. Ooh. Wow! Was that a whip punish or was that just. You're amazing. Oh my god, you're sweeping. Okay, this neutral jump is blowing me up. Oh, I should have just EX uppercut. EX uppercut would have killed. I wasn't looking at the life bar. EX uppercut would have killed, but I was so already in my brain like go super.
Round two.
Okay. Dang it, this neutral jump is pissing me off. What in the world was that? I was almost really, 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 really sad about that. I have to remember, once I activate V-Trigger, use Roundhouse Uppercut, because it's actually invincible. Ugh. Foolish me. Alright. So basically, this Ken plays by neutral jumping, roundhousing, or running. So I'm trying to keep all three in mind at the same time, which is actually pretty tough. Oh my god, really? Oh god, I cannot play anymore. I'm not gonna uppercut, I'm just gonna back medium punch because I can't tell what's going on. Neutral jumping! Please stop neutral jumping! No, go ahead, keep neutral jumping. Oh, nice dash! Okay. Oh, Jesus. I can't see. Oh my god, did you really do that? That was awesome! But the lag is starting to kick in. Oh god. Dang it. I just want to get this out of the way because the lag is killing me right now. So, okay. Whoops! That's no good. That was nice. I don't think this is gonna kill. I don't think this is gonna kill. No, it's definitely not gonna kill. How did I dash the wrong way? Ooh, that wasn't even a combo. I should have did crouching medium punch. I should have did crouching medium punch. Is it gonna kill? Is it gonna kill? It's so funny. I didn't even notice I said that every single time until everyone started pointing it out. Now it's just something that I have to be completely aware of. Okay. So every time the super lands now, but I mean, nowadays I feel like I have to say it. Now I have to emphasize it. I have to be like, boom, boom, is it gonna kill? Like I should do it in like different voices every single day, every single time. I'm gonna be like, is it going to kill? I have to do that every time now. Every time it's about to kill, I have to like say it in different ways. Is it going to kill? Is this going to kill? You know. Oh my, I'm not sure if this is gonna kill or not. You know, do some bad Australian accents and everything. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to say it all the time now. Sorry guys, you're just gonna have to live with it now. Problem with that hooligan is that it doesn't combo after that, if I'm not- Oh, it does! Okay. I always thought it didn't combo after that. Okay. But that- that's annoying. No, I don't know if that's squeaky enough. I don't know if that's a squeaky enough girl voice right there. See you later, Ultima's Rage. Peace out. Could this possibly be a situation where this person may lose if this critical art may do enough damage? I think I'm gonna do that now. I think I'm just gonna keep doing it. Oh, that's us. See, this is the worst thing about, that's a sick color. I love the color, I love the outfit, the hat has the Delta Red logo on it, like really nicely there. I mean, the normal one does too, but like she's got the tie and just looks so sick, and then all of a sudden, no pants, no pants. God, come on. Oh my God, you just regular uppercutted. Holy crap. Back medium punch, that's nice, because that's 4 frames. That's definitely a good button to poke with in that situation. Oh, come on, you're camp, you should know about that. Yeah, meaty standing light kicks, and I've learned to eye it a little bit better, and it's such a crucial mix-up over standing medium punch. My crush counter sucks. Oh, that was a combo. Oh, she caught my backdash! Oh no. Really? 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 This is an option. That was kind of sick too. Alright, alright, alright. If she had chance, they'd reduce the range of her kicks. You know, I might actually be willing to accept that. Like, I would play that version of the costume with pants if they reduced the range of the kicks by like 3 pixels. I'm totally down with that. Yeah, only the colors for the costume that you unlock with. Yes, that is true. That is true. Come on, let's go this. Let's do this. Oops, I forgot to take off the stupid white coat again. Oh, nice. Hey, that's what I was talking about. Nice! Good stuff, good stuff. This is the Cammy round right here. This is where Cammy gets bodied. Okay, forgot that move existed. Fair enough. Fair enough. I will take that. Dang, nice confirmed. Oh my god, you swept. I mean, wow, good reactions on your part. Whoops. Whoops, whoopsie. I tried to do EX uppercut, but I forgot I had another thing. But still, regular uppercut should have came out. I don't know why regular uppercut didn't come out. What the hell? I fell to the other side. I don't know why I wasted the super that way. That was actually a really terrible idea. Roundhouse reached far. I was just hitting it on the way, dude. So that's just proof right there of how different it is when you're playing a game where the neutral jump buttons are the same as the diagonal jump buttons. I always feel like the neutral jump buttons in this game are so much better than they've ever been, and that's actually one of the reasons why, is because they are the diagonal jump buttons. Those have to be designed to reach a decent distance. So when you give it to them in neutral, it's really powerful, which is why in most of the other games they gave them different neutral jump attacks. I understand why they don't in this game, because they wanted to lower the number of different moves in the game. But you can see its effect right there. You know, neutral jump becomes a lot more powerful thanks to these things. How many Street Fighter V haters only played Street Fighter IV in their life? Probably a lot of them. Probably a lot of them. So, thank you, Masafel. That's actually very nice. The game is whack, but I like James. Thank you. Thank you. Well, I mean, you could be talking about James the Powerhead, to be honest with you, because James the Powerhead is pretty awesome, not gonna lie, right? I mean, that guy is pretty slick himself, and he's in this chat all the time, so for sure, I could totally understand if he's the reason why you're here. That totally makes sense. Shoutouts to Tanta for the follow. Thank you very much. Trash talking is a part of esports. Kind of. It's talking trash is part of esports in the right way. So, hey, Jansen Lives, I'm totally down with that too. If I'm whack, and but you like this game, that's cool. I'm totally down with that too. So. Yeah, I mean, I think. It's really interesting. Yeah, I'm only playing ranked Iron God. I know that you've wanted to play for a very long time, but I'm only doing ranked because I just really want to show like strategies on how to play this particular mode and how to assess players quickly. Long sets doesn't let me get the chance to do that kind of assessment. All right, so let's see what kind of Ryu player this is. He is going to back off. Okay, a little bit of forward dash towards heavy punch, which is a good button. Okay, he came forward. So he's definitely a forward moving Ryu. See? He dashed forward there. So That is something I'm gonna have to be aware of, so that's why I'm hitting out buttons like that. Okay, and he did a quick rise instead of a back roll. Oh, nice, I like that. Okay, he gets the throw, so he's not ready to tech just yet. I love that forward dash on his wake up! Good stuff to the Ryu. Okay, forward dash and a throw. Good. I like it. Oh, okay. Oh, empty jump and a throw. Oh my god, he just uppercutted? He just uppercutted? Okay, I actually do like the way this Ryu is playing footsies. Very tough to deal with. Oops. Tried to uppercut, just didn't get it out in time. Oh god. Oh, that was supposed to be jump EX dive kick. Not what I meant to do. Yeah. He's getting a little predictable with the forward movement, so I was trying to bait him by walking away, looking like I went super defensive. I was looking for him to dash forward so I could do Crouch Fierce into that, so. Yeah, very forward movement heavy Ryu. The good timing choices on it. I gotta take the damage right now. I gotta get him nervous. I gotta get the life tied up so that he thinks about it a little bit. Yeah, same thing. See, a little predictable on that forward movement timing. Ooh, that was so close! If he had Torch Fierce me, I would have been in so much pain! Holy crap! Holy crap, holy crap. SF4 was harder to play than 5, mostly because about the execution. Although the footsies in Street Fighter 4, I don't know if necessarily were back to Ultra Gold. I don't know if the footsies are necessarily as complex, mostly because in Street Fighter 4, a lot of people had one button footsies, like Adon was just like roundhouse, 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 roundhouse. Now he's jumping. I like it. I like that he's added that to his game. Good throw. There's still no text. Okay, now he's gonna try to dash up and throw me. Right now what I'm reading is that he plays defensive with fireballs to try to get me to stop hitting buttons, and then he can dash up on me. So I'm letting him kind of hang himself with that. I'm letting him throw these fireballs. He always throws 2 fireballs, and then he dashes forward. 1, 2, dash forward. Oh, see, he stopped, okay. But he had been doing that. Whoops, he dashed forward. Okay, I'm in a bad situation here. Just get out of here. I don't know why I EX'd. Standing light punch. Okay, I stand up there too much. See, he did it again. See, every time I wanted to do a lot of damage, it was about waiting till he dashed forward and then I'd hit him with a button into V-trigger. Like, I think I won 4 rounds that, like 3 of the 4 rounds that way. I was just waiting for him to dash forward and then I would react to that by hitting a button. And isn't it funny? Isn't it funny how my reaction to dash forward is so nice? Is nice. Like that's nice, James. It's nice, right? Like, good stuff, James. But my reaction to jump is so god awful. Again, it has so little to do with my reaction timing. It's just putting the right thing in that reactions box. I haven't been able to rip that out. It's like cemented in there with 20 years of rust and grime and dirt and glue and just caked in there. Like, there's so much earwax in there and I just have to give it like a proper lavage, but it's just taking forever and I can't get anything out of there. So, one of the things that I learned last week was that nourishment was important. Probably also taking breaks a couple of times is important. So I am gonna try to take a break every hour or so. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and take a break, come back after I run a few ads and everything like that. And then when I come back, I'll keep playing and then I'll probably answer some questions as well, because I know a lot of people probably wanna talk about the CPT stuff like that. So I'm totally down to answer some questions about that as well. So the pattern that I have when I play is I play, I do well at the beginning, I start sucking in the middle, and then everything goes down and I get salty. So I'm gonna try to change the regimen a little bit and see if I can do this more properly. So I'm gonna take a quick break. When I come back, more online matches, and I'll talk to some of the chat and answer some questions. Okay, and water. And I don't have water down here. You know what? I need to get water down here. Okay, I'll go grab some water as well. So I'll be right back, guys. I will be right back.